हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल होम्योपैथी केयर। माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर ज्योति सुंदर त्रिपाठी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एनीमिया एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एनीमिया एंड इन्वेस्टिगेशंस एंड डेफिनेशन ऑफ द एनीमिया। एनीमिया इज डिफाइंड एज द हीमोग्लोबिन कंसेंट्रेशन इन ब्लड बिलो द लोअर लिमिट ऑफ द नॉर्मल रेंज फॉर द सेक्स एंड एज ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल्स। In adult, the lower extremities of normal HB is taken as 13 gram per day for male and 11.5 gram or 12 grams per day for females. And newborn infants are higher hemoglobin level, therefore 15 mg gram per is taken is the lower limits at birth, and whereas the 3 month the normal lower level is 9.5 gram per day is normal. Pathophysiology of anemia. Subnormal level of the HB cause lowered oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, thus in turn initiate compensatory physiological adaptations such as follow: increase release of oxygen from HB and increase blood flow to the tissue, and maintenance of blood volume and redistribution of blood flow to maintain the cerebral distribution, the cerebral blood supply. Clinical feature of the anemia. The hemoglobin level at the which symptoms and signs of anemia develop depend upon four main factors. First is the speed of onset of anemia. Rapidly progressive anemia cause more symptoms than anemia of slow onset, as there is less time of physiologic adaptation. And severity of anemia. Mild anemia produce no symptoms and sign, but a rapidly progressive severe anemia HB below 6 mg per dl may produce significant clinical features. The age of the patient. Young patient due to good cardiovascular compensation tolerate anemia quite well as compared to the elderly, and elderly patient develop cardiac and cerebral symptoms more prominently due to associated serious disease. And then hemoglobin dissociation curve. The in anemia the affinity of HB for oxygen is depressed as 2-3 BPG in the red cell increases. As a result, oxyhemoglobin is dissociated more readily to release free oxygen for cellular use, causing a shift of the hemoglobin dissociation curve to the right. Symptoms. In symptomatic case of anemia, the presenting features are tiredness, easy fatigue, generalized muscular weakness, lethargy, headache, faintness, confusion. Like symptoms are appear in old patient, there may be symptoms of cardiac failure or angina pectoris, intermittent claudication, confusion and visual disturbance. Sign. A few general signs common in all type of anemia are as under. First is the pallorness. Pallor is the most common and characteristic signs which may seen in the mucous membrane, conjunctiva and skin. Second is the cardiovascular system. A hyperdynamic circulation may be present with tachycardia, collapsed pulse, cardiomegaly, mid-systolic flow murmur, dyspnea on exertion, and in the case of elderly, congestive heart failure. In central nervous system, symptoms like old patient may develop symptoms referred as the CNS, such as attack of faintness, giddiness, headache, tinnitus, drowsiness, numbness, tingling sensation of the hands and feet. Ocular manifestations. Retinal hemorrhage may occur if there is associated vascular disease or bleeding diathesis, and reproductive systems of menstrual disturbance such as amenorrhea due to low HB and menorrhagia or loss of libido are some of the manifestations involving the reproductive systems of anemic subjects. And renal system, mild proteinuria and impaired concentrating capacity of the kidney may occur in severe anemia. Gastrointestinal systems are symptoms produced like anorexia, flatulence, nausea, constipation, weight loss may occur. Investigation of the anemia. First is the most important investigation of Hb estimation. Second is the peripheral blood film examination. Third is the red cell indices. Red cell indices and alternative methods to diagnosis and detect the severity of anemia is by measuring the red cell indices. In iron deficiency and thalassemia, MCV, mean corpuscular volume, mean corpuscular hemoglobin and mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration are reduced in iron deficiency and thalassemia. In anemia due to acute blood loss or hemolytic anemia, MCV, MCH or MCSC are within normal limits. Okay, and megaloblastic anemia in CV is raised above the normal range. Leukocytes and platelets count. Measure the leukocyte and platelets count help to distinguish anemia from pancytopenia, in which red cells, granulocytes and platelets are reduced. In anemia due to hemolysis or hemorrhage, the neutrophils count are always increased and platelets count are increased. And in infectious cell leukemia, cancerous conditions like leukocyte count are high and immature leukocytes appear in the blood. Reticulocytes. So reticulocyte count normal 0.5 to 2.5% is done in each cases of anemia to assess the marrow erythropoietic activity. In acute hemorrhage and in hemolysis, the reticulocytes response in indicative of impaired marrow function. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate, ESR, is a non-specific test used in screening test for anemia. It is usually give a clue to the underlying organic disease, but anemia itself may also cause rise in the ESR. And bone marrow examination is done in case where the case cause of anemia is not obvious. Classification of the anemia. Several types of classification of anemia have been proposed. Some of the widely accepted classification are based on the pathophysiologic and morphological. And first is the pathophysiological classification. Depending upon the pathophysiologic mechanism, anemia is classified into two groups. First is the anemia due to blood loss. Second is the anemia due to red cell productions decreased, inadequate, and third is the anemia due to destructions of the blood cells, red blood cells. First is the anemia due to blood loss are further divided into two types. First is the acute post hemorrhagic anemia and second is the anemia of the chronic blood loss. Second type, anemia due to impaired red cell formations, red cells productions for various causes may produce anemia, these are as under cytoplasmic mutation defect, causes deficiency of synthesis, cause iron deficiency anemia, and deficient globin synthesis for thalassemic syndrome. And second type of nuclear maturation defect cause vitamin B12 and folic acid deficiency like megaloblastic anemia, produce megaloblastic anemia. Third type of hematopoietic stem cell proliferation and differentiation abnormalities produce aplastic anemia and pure red cell aplasia. Fourth type of bone marrow failure due to systemic disease, anemia of chronic disorders. Like first is the anemia of infiltration, inflammation, infections are some such type of malignancies. And anemia of the renal diseases due to endocrine nutritional deficiency, hypometabolic state, and anemia in the liver diseases. Bone marrow infiltrations like produce leukemia, lymphomas, and myelosclerosis, multiple myeloma. And congenital anemia produce a sideroblastic anemia and congenital dysarthropoietic anemia. And the third type of anemia, anemia due to increased red blood cell destructions like hemolytic anemia are further divided into two groups. Intracorpuscular defect are hereditary and acquired type of, and second is the extracorpuscular defect, acquired hemolytic anemia are presented and produces, okay. एंड मॉर्फोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन बेस्ड ऑन द सेल रेड सेल साइज एंड हीमोग्लोबिन कंटेंट या आर एंड हीमोस रेड सेल्स इंडाइसिस एनीमिया आर क्लासिफाइड इंटू टू थ्री ग्रुप्स. फर्स्ट इज द माइक्रोसाइटिक हाइपोक्रोमिक इज नेम इज शो एंड माइक्रो ऑल सेल्स आर डिक्रीज इन रेंज. तो MCV, MCH और MCSC आर ऑलवेज रिड्यूस्ड इन आयरन डेफिशिएंसी एंड एनीमिया एंड सर्टेन नॉन आयरन डेफिशिएंसी एनीमिया लाइक सिड्रोब्लास्टिक एनीमिया, थैलेसीमिया एंड एनीमिया ऑफ द क्रोनिक डिसऑर्डर्स. सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ नॉर्मोसाइटिक एंड नॉर्मोक्रोमिक नेम शो द ऑल सेल्स आर नॉर्मल रेंज. MCV, MCH और MCSC आर ऑल आर नॉर्मल. After acute blood loss or hemolytic anemia or bone marrow failure and anemia of the chronic disorders. Microcytic anemia. Microcytic is MCV is raised in megaloblastic anemia due to deficiency of the vitamin B12 and folic acid. With these general comments of anemia, I discussed another topic. Anemia of the blood loss depending on the two types. First is the acute blood loss and second is the chronic blood loss. Acute blood loss, when the loss of blood occurs suddenly, the following events take place: immediately threat of life due to hypovolemia, which may result in shock and death. If the patient survives, shifting of interstitial fluid to intravascular compartment or consequently hemodilutions with low hemocrit. Yeah, our third is the hypoxic stimulate productions of erythropoietin in resulting in increased marrow erythropoiesis. Some laboratory tests are normocytic normochromic anemia, low hematocrit, and the third is the increased reticulocyte count in peripheral blood. Chronic blood loss, when the loss of blood is slow and insidious, the effect of anemia will become apparent only when the rate of loss is more than rate of productions and iron store are depleted.
So much for watching my video.